Welcome to another NUCIDA video. If you like it, please give this video a thumbs up, subscribe to this channel, and click the bell. Never forget our upcoming sessions. If you have any questions or hints, please leave a comment. Our certified QA experts will reply in time. We recently introduced descriptive programming using a small example script. Today I would like to show in detail how I have used this nested init data from table function here. I use this DDT report row to specify the name of the sheet to be used. Apart from the global table, this can of course contain all other data in different sheets that are necessary and useful for the automated test. In this case, the global row is the one that contains all the relevant data. In the two columns, field names are entered at the top, which have a unique field name, without special characters and spaces. These field variables are then used by a function such as dataTableValue to assign the information in question to corresponding script variables for further use. This is normally done via a call such as this dataTableValue, then the value of the. The table search item object represents our table, which is passed to the inSearchItem variable here. The data it contains is then used later in the checkSearchOutput function. The individual fields contain longer strings that are used to verify the displayed result after the search result. Now, I am going to start the script. If I open the view, we can see which variables are currently being used. For example, the inSearchItem variable to search for a value that was entered in the search field of the form. And here is the value after checking for a web element, which I then present after the search. I'll click through this briefly, and then we can see what changes have been made. So, the search value has already been entered here. This now continues, and then we see that the values have been initialized here. I'll let it continue now. The values are entered, and now this value is also verified by UFT1 down here. This takes a little longer until it has found it, because this is also a larger value that has to be compared here. Now we move on to the next iteration. Now you can also see that it has oriented itself to the next table row, because this is already marked here. UFT1 will now gradually draw the values from the second row. Here it still has the old value from the first iteration, because this is a global variable, and it does not change at first. However, if I now press F10, we see that we are already searching for the search string UFT1AI. Previously, it was only UFT1. Now we see the input of UFT AI, and further down UFT1's AI object detection is to be found. Again, this only takes a moment, but then UFT1 finds it. Then we come to the next iteration, and here we still see UFT1. I go one step further again, and now we have descriptive programming. That's what we're looking for next in the third iteration. This is also automatically found and checked by UFT1. And lo and behold, we are through. We can take another look at the test result from UFT1 in the browser. Here we come directly to the initialization of the test case via the common library, which previously initialized the appearance and the sequence. After the start of the first iteration with the keyword action1 from the script, we can see that the function has been called, and the data from the global sheet has been read out in the first line. These values were then determined. This means that we now initialize these variables with these values, whereby we can also use somewhat longer text here. After initialization, the actual test starts. The browser starts the web search. The search text is then entered in the edit field. UFT1 then presses the search button. Then a screenshot is taken of the test object. The check is then carried out according to what is being searched for. This is done once according to the search value in the default box, which then appears. This is compared with the content from the second column. If both contents are the same, this results in a pass, or the test is successful. If you like it, please give this video a thumbs up, subscribe to this channel, and click the bell. Never forget our upcoming sessions. If you have any questions or hints, please leave a comment. Our ISTQB, ITK, X-Ray, and TestRail certified QA experts will reply in time or even produce a separate video about your topic. Please also check out our other over 200 videos about software quality. Happy testing. See you next time.